Hey guys, welcome back. This is Kanhai. Today I'm just going to give you a quick guide of the speedometer of the new Triumph Street Triple S. So when you basically start your motorcycle, this is the kind of display you get, followed by which you go to the kill switch, which is also your engine starter button, and your bike is on. Now for the speedometer, you have only two buttons. This is the setup button and this is the button for select. This basically allows you to flick through different options and this allows you to lock onto it. I'll just give you a walk around. TTC is basically traction control. Traction control can be switched on and off. However, do note that this only applies for the road mode. For the rain mode, the traction control is on by default. Your next setting you get is your time setting, wherein you can adjust the time over here on the clock. After that, you have a service interval. Now, as you can see, my bike is already due for servicing. It gives you either the kilometers left or how many kilometers you are over the service interval. Shift light. The shift light can be adjusted into different ways. Either you can have a flickering light like this. You can have, you can set the RPM at what RPM do you want the shift light to get on. Though I do not like the shift light much, primarily because it is a lot of, you could say, distraction while riding at night. The LEDs are really bright, and especially at night with the helmet on, a bright light directly on your face is not a good idea. So here you set your units. In units you can choose from miles per gallon or kilometers per liter, miles per hour or kilometers per hour, basically. And you have a return option. On return is basically your back to the setup. Now for the shift lights, let me just show you. You can have it off. You can have six lights which light up as you get individually as you reach the RPM. You can have three lights, what I have on right now, or you can have lights which are dancing all the time. I personally like the switched off mode, so I have no distractions. And that's about it. So do let me know if you have any other doubts. I will be showing you more features from this bike. I have had a lot of comments, just 5-6 comments basically, but from people who are genuinely interested in knowing or buying this bike. So if you are thinking about this bike, please do get back to me. Till then, ciao, ride safe.